My dear students, now I am going to explain you two concepts in genetics which most of the students are getting confusion during their studies. The concepts are, the first one, sex limited genes, second one is sex influenced genes. See, there is a very close in the terminology, sex limited genes, sex influenced genes. Now I'll clarify you what these two are. First one, sex limited genes. So the genes, the autosomal genes which are present in male and female but express in only one gender, are known as sex limited genes. For example, the gene, if this is a gene present in male and female, If it expresses in male, it won't express in female. If it expresses in female, it won't express in male. So these are called as sex limited genes. They are limiting for one sex, and other side it won't. But it will be present in both. The gene present in male and female as well. So example I'll give you, breast development of breast gene. The gene responsible for development of breast. The gene is present in female and male. See, the breast development, for the breast development, the gene is present in male also, but it expresses in only female. It won't express in male. The reason is what? The environmental condition, female is different to male. So the environment supports this gene to express, so that it expresses in female, so that breast will form in a female body, and the environment condition in male is different, so there are no estrogen and other hormones, so that this gene won't express in male. And beard formation gene, another example. This beard formation gene is present in female also. Beard formation gene is present in female also, but there is no appearance of beard in female. Why? Because it is limiting to one sex, only male. So these genes are known as sex limited genes. Got it? Now let us move for the second concept, sex influenced genes. Sex influenced genes. So the autosomal genes present in both male and female. So same thing here, the genes present in both male and female, but they behave differently in male and female. They behave differently. Before that, what? If it expresses in male, it is not expressing in female, right? But it expresses in both, but differently it expresses. That is called as sex influenced genes. Sex influenced genes, what? It expresses the gene. Express in both, but differently it expresses. Example, the gene responsible for bald head. If the gene is present in male, what happens? You know, there is a huge hair fall, hair loss, not fall, hair loss, and there is no hair on head, bald head. If the gene is present in female, will you see bald head in female? No. It behaves differently. There is a hair fall. They will have loss of hair. They lose the hair, but not like men. Got it? So sex limited, sex influenced. I repeat you. Sex limited means what? The gene present in male and female, but it expresses only one gender, and it won't express in another gender because of environmental condition. And the second one, sex influenced genes. The genes present in both male and female and express in both, but differently expresses. This is called as sex influenced genes. Of course, this expression of bald head in male, not expressing bald head in a female, is also controlled by environmental condition. So these are the two terminology most of the students will get confused. I think you clarified with this video.